this week in the vegetable garden, we can plant our melons and we can also start to harvest our lettuce, spinach, and other greens. I like to harvest my lettuce a little bit at a time and eat it as I go along. Another task I have for today is to plant flowers to attract beneficial insects. There are a number of insect allies that we have in our garden. They're our friends. These include things like predators, which are beetles, wasps, ants, and true bugs, and these feed on our pest insects. We also have a group called parasitoids, which are tiny wasps that attack and kill some of our smaller pests, insects like aphids. One of the best ways to attract insect allies to our garden is by planting resources for them, and these resources are flowers. In addition to eating insects, they also need a source of sugar, which they get from nectar in our flowers. And there's several groups of plants that have very rich nectaries and provide a lot of what our insect friends need. The first group would be the asters, and that includes plants like echinaceas and calendula, our zinnias, and our gallardia. And we want to find plants that have rich nectaries, so sometimes those with a double flower aren't as good as the single flower because the nectaries are more exposed for the insects. Another group of plants that's really good for attracting natural enemies are herbs, especially those in the carrot family, things such as fennel and dill. And also some of our pea plants, our legumes, like clover and alfalfa, which also make great cover crops. There are a number of plants in the mustard family, such as the sweet alyssum, and these are wonderful for attracting natural enemies, especially the wasps, because they have very small nectaries. A lot of people plant the marigolds around their gardens, and this is something we've done traditionally. My mom thought it helped keep rabbits away. Other people think that it keeps insects away, and there's not good research to support that, but there is research that shows marigolds help keep nematodes away, which attack the roots, so they certainly are welcome around our vegetable gardens. So what I like to do is find any open space I have available and stick some flowers in there. I like to choose things that maybe don't need a lot of extra help, plants that might be a little bit more drought tolerant. This is also a good practice, flowers around our evergreens, so that there are resources for natural enemies to control pests on our ornamental plants. Of course, all these flowers are also going to attract pollinators to the garden, which is an added benefit.